Hi students, so good morning to all of you. How are you everybody? I think everybody fine. Okay my dear students, today's session I will explain structure of Java. Last session we discussed it. Introduction to Java, Java features, some basic concepts in Java, I explained. But today's session, I will explain structure of Java. Without structure, we will not implement any program. If you want to implement any program, is must understand what happened. We are following the some structure. Based on structure only, what happened? We are writing the program statement one by one. One order. Already, I think everybody learned structure of C, structure of C++ also. I think everyone know structure of C, documentation section, linked section, definition section, global variable, declaration section, main function, local variable, declaration part, this or no. Then method, declaration, everything, I think you learned it C language. But similarly, you want to write the program in Java means, so must and should everybody learn the structure of Java. So based on the structure, then based on that order only, we are writing the statements simultaneously. Understand? Now, in structure of Java program, various sections are there. I will explain each and every sections one by one. So first section, documentation section. Documentation section. Second one, Package statement. Third one, import statement. Next, interface statement. Next, class definition. Next, main function. Then next, local variable declaration part. Then executable part. Executable part means that is method behavior, whatever. So first one we'll discuss documentation section. So it is also called as a comment section. So we are writing any statements in the comment section means at the runtime it will not take. At the programming runtime it will not take any statements. It is also called as a comment section. So I will explain one by one. First, documentation section, that is also called as a comment section. Okay, na? Comments. Comment section. That is, comment section means just writing some comments about the program. What is the program name? Program author name? Okay, some program description. Everything we specified. The comment section. So that regards here we are using some symbols. So first one is, for example, slash asterisk, then comments, then asterisk slash. This is the first category. Second category or so slash double slash then double slash. So double slash comments then double slash. Okay, or other way, so slash, so mention the place all of carefully observe, two asterisk, then mention the some comments, then asterisk slash. So within a comments, within a symbols, you can mention the some comments, program name, author name, program description, whatever. So that is called as a documentation section, some documents about the program. I think everybody learned in C language. Then next one is, second one is package statement. Package statement. Package statement. So package, I think my dear students, it is also a new concept. I think this concept not available, you are not learning C language, it is a new concept in Java. Yes or no? So please all of you carefully listen, carefully observe. So whenever, okay, I am telling new words or new concept, please at this moment, please all of you carefully observe, carefully listen. Okay. So package statement. Package means so set of classes. Set of classes. So class means so set of properties and methods. Set of properties and methods. So that set of classes known as a package. So this package statements, what happened? You can mention the after documentation section. Okay, na? How to mention the package statement? What is the syntax? Here using keyword as package. Then package name. Package name. Okay, na? For example, package. Then package name is, for example, employee, semicolon. Here mention some classes. Class A. Then class B. In this manner, you can create the package. In the example. Okay, na? So, I think everyone know. So, class means set of properties and methods that is known as a class. Okay. These set of classes, how many classes are there? Two classes. One is A, another one is B. Okay. So, these two classes, what happen? So, they are writing code again, employee package. Okay. So, I think we'll discuss this package concept in Unit 3. Okay. At this moment, we'll discuss very deeply about package. But now, please, all of you, just listen. What is package? What is the usage? Where you can specify the package? Okay. So, package means set of classes. How to creating the package means using keyword as package. P-A-C-K-A-G-E. Package. Then package name. It is a syntax. It is an example. Package space employee. Then class name. Okay. Then set of properties. That means mention the variables and methods whatever. That is. So this type of any points mentioned in second category. Second section. That is package statement. Then next one is import statement. What is the next one? Third one. Import statement. Import statement. My dear students, here I think everyone know C header files, hash include std.h, hash include conio.h, hash include standard input output header files. Yes or no? Std.h, hash include conio.h, console input output header files. However, these header files we are utilizing in the C language. In same manner, what happened? In Java programming also we are using the import statements. We want so properly work the input statements and output statement means what happened? First of all, we import the input output function from the JDK, Java Development Kit. So initially what happened? You can install the JDK. Install the JDK, Java Development Kit. You can install the JDK. So in the JDK what happened? You can import the input output functionalities. That is, so that regards here what happened? You're using import Java dot io dot asp. So automatically what happens, you import the input output functions. Input means you can read the value through keyboard. Output means display the output on the screen. Display the outputs on the screen means what happens using output. Okay, I think everyone know in C language how to display any statement. How to display any statement? Print function. How to read any values in C language means scanf. Similarly, output means then how to display any statement in Java Lang means system.out.println. Later I will explain on example program. There are clearly I will explain each and every point. Okay, what is system.out.println? So system.out.println means you can display the statement on the screen. Then input means you read the data through keyboard. So just like a scanner. Here we are using scanner. This is the scanner. So that triggers to import the one more file. That is import java dot util dot asterisk. Util package. Import java dot util dot asterisk. Okay, my dear students. Here if you want display statement. Display any statement on the screen means. So what is that? System dot out dot println. Println. Then statement. It is double quotation mention. It is the syntax. System dot out dot println, then statement. My dear students, all of you carefully listen. Java is a case sensitive language. Case sensitive language. Here clearly mentioned lowercase letters as well as uppercase letters. Here S is the uppercase letter. System dot out dot println S is the uppercase letter. Because Java is a case sensitive language. So that regards some cases, some letters are lowercase, some cases, some letters are uppercase. That means first character is must and should mandatorily mention the uppercase. So please all of you keep this point in your mind. That is display. Then read means read. So using scanner command. So scanner, yes, caps. Scanner space object name is equal to new space scanner space system.in. System.in. So here S is a caps. Scanner space object name is equal to new space scanner system.in. Okay, my dear students. Then through the object you can read. I will explain later clearly how to read the values. I will take one variable, then I will explain how to read the values, then how to display the value, how to manipulate the any two variables. Everything I will explain. First, basic. What is import statement? Import statement means you want any files means what happened? Maybe files means you can import from the JDK, Java Development Kit. So many versions are there. JDK 1.5, 1.6, 1.7, 1.8, whatever. So latest version, whatever is there. So please all of you install the latest version in your labs. Then, if you at the program writing time, if you want to import any file space, label file means, then what happens? Import. This is the command. Import space java.io.asterisk. So read means, if you want to read any values means, must ensure what happened. So mention the import java.util.asterisk. So that is about import statement. Then next one is interface statement. Interface statement. Interface statement. Here interface means just like a class. Java does not support multiple inheritance. Okay. Here in Java programming one concept is there. Okay. That is inheritance concept. Single inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance, hybrid inheritance. But C++ supports all these categories. But Java does not support multiple inheritance. At this moment, what happened? We are using the interface concept. Interface also just like a class. Okay. Inheriting is acquiring the properties from one class to another class. Okay. But Java does not support multiple inheritance. At this moment, that is base classes are what happened, just convert into interface. I think this interface concept also comes in unit 3 or unit 2. So in that moment I will explain very clearly. Okay, but all of it is just some simple knowledge about interface. Interface means just like a class. What is a class? Class is a set of properties and methods. Okay, now how to create interface? Interface name. Interface name. Then mention set of variables, then set of methods. So these type of statements what happened? So depending fourth section, that is interface statement. Then mention class. Class. Then next one is class name. So for example, okay, student. So class, then student, then main function. So here next one is main function using Java programming, public static void main. Public static void main. Then string arguments. String arguments. So access specifiers. There are four access specifiers available in Java. That is private, public, protect, package. So private means for local variable purpose. Within a class, we are using private. So public means you can access the, you can invoke the variables from the one class to another class, means what happened using public. Then static, then void, does not return a value. Then main function, then string arguments. So whatever else is given in Java programming, that entire value is what happened converted to string form. Okay, so that is public, static, void, main, string arguments. So these are the syntax. So in this manner only what happened, we are writing the any program, Java programming. Understand, my dear students? So first one is documentation section, that is comments purpose using the documentation section. Already I explained, that is just tell about program name, author name and program description. So everything you can specify in the documentation section. Then next one is package statement. Okay, the package statement means set of classes. Okay, so if you want to import the if you communicate the program to program, understand. Inheritance means, one more concept is there, I already explained. Inheritance means, so just it will communication between the class to class. Just invoke the properties from one class to another class. That is inheritance. But package means, just you can access the information from the one program to another program. One program to another program. Okay. So if you want to develop any projects, okay, in that time must understand what happened, okay. So separate the, so different classes and different program wise. In that situation what happened, we are using the package concept, the set of classes. Then how to declare a package, what is the syntax, package space, package name. So for example, package employee is contained in two classes, class A, class B. Then import statement, if you want to import the any functionalities from the JDK, Java Development Kit means, then what happened, import java.io.ashtray. So here, available the input-output function. Okay, so if you want to display any statement means, then using system.out.println. So the system.out.println properly working means, you can mention the import java.io.ashtray. Then if you want to read any values, for example, summation of two numbers, that means c equal to a plus b. In this situation, what happened, enter the two values, a and b value. So a value is 10, then b value is 20. Then just you can sum the two values, a and b. So 10 plus 20, 30. In the situation what happened, you enter the some values through keyboard. You enter the a value and b value, enter through keyboard. So in the situation what happened, you read the values through keyboard. So read means, I think in C language how to read scanner. In Java means how to read through this command. Scanner space object name is equal to new space scanner system.in. So whenever you can mention the statement, must should what happened, mention the just import this statement, that is util package. Import java.util.ashtray. Understand, my students? Then next one is, fourth one is, what is the fourth section? Interface statement. Interface also just like a class. Why we are using interface concept means, so Java does not support multiple inheritance. So in that moment what happened? So just that class is converted to interface. So what is the syntax means? Interface space interface name. Here we mention the properties. That means class properties. That is variables. Then simply mention the methods. However, we are utilizing the class in same manner we are utilizing the interface. That's it. There's no any difference. Okay. The next one is main function. I mean class definition. So class name, whatever class name you mention. Please all of you carefully listen. Whatever class name you given, so through that name only you can save the program. For example, here class name is, for example, student. What is the class name? Student. Now we are saving the program. How to save the program? student.java. Student.java. How to save the program? That is class name dot java extension. Okay, that is class. Then next one is main function. So in Java programming, what happened mentioned in this manner: public space static space void space main string arguments. So here public are the access specifiers. So there are four access specifiers available: private, public, protected, package. Here mentioned the public. Okay, so private means local purpose, public means one class to another class, then protect means inheriting concept using the protect, then package means already we discussed. So if you want to import the any variables or any methods from one program to another program is using the package. But here mentioned public, static, void, main, then string arguments. So whatever all is given Java programming, the everything is whatever connected to string arguments. That's the main thing. Okay, so in this manner we are writing the program. Then next, and save the program, then compile the program, then run the program, then automatically you will get output. So next session, I will explain one simple example program. So just display the program, similarly what happened, read the another program. Okay, so in that situation, you will clearly understand my concept. Okay, how to display the any statement, then how to read and display the values. Okay, so next session, I will tell simple example. Okay, my dear students. So thanks to everyone. I think if you have any doubt, my dear students, please contact me through my mobile number. So my mobile number is 970-54-0995. Then please all of you contact me through my mail ID also. That is deepakkumarsvphd@gmail.com. Thank you, my dear students. Thank you.